Alright, so this is this week's Sports Ass Take, and we're breaking down the Pelicans and Kings blockbuster deal. So the Pelicans received Demarcus Cousins and Omri Caspi.
Keep in mind, though, that Omri Caspi is out 4 to 6 weeks. On the Kings side, though, they received Buddy Hield, Tyreek Evans, but he is to be waived, so that shouldn't help them that much. Langston Galloway, a 2017 first-round pick, and a 2017 second-round pick.
Alright, so I'm saying that this is a good deal for the Pelicans. They made a move, huge move to like keep Anthony Davis happy where he is. In the 3-4 years that he's been there, there's been nothing around him, basically. And they finally got an all-NBA player to put next to him. And so you're going to have these twin towers in the paint. Omri Caspi, he's a great forward, great three-point shooter. He's out 4 to 6 weeks, but that was only because he got injured last night in the game.
Now, since saying that Demarcus Cousins really helps out Anthony Davis, I think all that Demarcus Cousins is really going to do is eat up Davis's touches. On the Kings side, however, they're getting Buddy Hield, the guy they really wanted. And they're getting these two picks, even though from the Pelicans, who should give them a high pick. So are they protected?
No, they're not.
So therefore, they should be getting a lottery level pick.
Top three protected.
Yeah.
The thing is, when you add Demarcus Cousins to your team, you're probably gonna win more games than you're projected to. So that first round pick is not gonna be as valuable. They'll move later to the draft. Second round pick is really like it's not as.
That's just a joke.
Yeah, it's basically a joke. Langston Galloway, also another joke. Buddy Hield. The reason they made this trade is because they were so high on him. I'm not as high on him as like they run at eBay. The owner was and. I think he's a little too high on him. He said he has Steph Curry potential, which is like really pushing it. The thing with this is when you put Demarcus Cousins on the Pelicans team, you're able to move Anthony Davis to forward, which is the position that he prefers and thrives in. And so by doing this, you have two monsters in the paint. Last night they showed it was a bad game. They got blown out by 30 points. So they showed that they can both play outside on the perimeter, spreading out the defense, and they can go 5 wide if they want with both these two bigs.
Now, Sid said they have the Twin Towers, and that's all great. But at the same time, you also said they got blown out by the Rockets. And what's coming from that, shown from that, is that two big men in the post is not going to stop guard play that dominates when you have subpar guards, considering that Jason Ray Wade or Tyreek Evans and Blake, or Jrue Holiday is not an all-NBA player. He's not going to carry the guard rotation.
Yeah, so that's a problem the Pelicans anyways have that they will have to address in the offseason. And so, like, I don't think that should be really held against them. They made a move that was projected like, to improve their team and to keep Anthony Davis basically happy after he signed like, monster extension. Because otherwise, they were in the running for like a bottom pick, like a larger pick again. And rebuilding is not something you'd want to do when you have a top 10 player like Anthony Davis. So, and I also don't really think that they lost much in Tyreek Evans and Buddy Hield. Buddy Hield has not been like playing exceptionally well. I think he's averaging like 8 points a game. Tyreek Evans has been like injured so often over the last couple of years. So yeah, I don't think it was a great loss on the Pelicans side compared to what they received.
I do want to point out though that the Kings did get rid of DeMarcus Cousins who was causing problems in the locker room accordingly, and there was just a divide on the team. And now that he's gone, they can form unity. And it was displayed last night when Willie Cauley-Stein dropped 29 points, and it showed that there's not really that much that they're losing at the center position. So I honestly think the Kings got a better deal.
Another problem I have with this trade is what the Kings return on this. Like, I understand that, okay, you want to get rid of DeMarcus Cousins, he's a problem in your locker room, you can make that argument, but you're also holding players like Ty Lawson, who's like a couple DUI arrests. You got like Aaron Afalo, who also had like problems, and just like not high character guys. You can't be going out there saying because he has a couple of technical fouls, he's a high character guy. And what they receive from this is not great. Again, we discussed this first round pick might not be as high as they want, which is not going to be a great return on an all NBA player. Buddy Hield, if he pans out to a step three potential, of course his trade's going to be good, but we haven't seen that from him yet, so you can't assume that. And so I felt like if they had waited out the market a little more or tried, did a better job, they would have got a better deal out of this. Even Vlade Divac said he had a better deal 2 days before, where that second round pick would have been another first round pick. So I really think they could have just gotten more from their all NBA player. And yeah, they just lost on this trade big.
I've made my point.
Alright, that's it.